Anxiety. An uncomfortable feeling of nervousness or worry about something that is happening or might happen in the future. Anxiety isn't talked enough about in skateboarding. Today, I'm here to do my part. After 14 years of skating, I still have anxious thoughts, and I guess they'll never fade away. I'd rather skate alone or with my significant other at some crusty parking lot than to go to a populated, picture-perfect skate park. Any spot where I'm alone is acceptable to me. A place where no one can hear me, look at me, or stare at me. I know that no one will judge me, especially not at a skate park. Yet, I still hate to go to one if there are people that I don't personally know. I always have this general feeling of disconnection with the people around me. It's nearly impossible to describe. But I'm sure the ones of you that are familiar with this feeling know what I mean. It's not that you dislike them, it just feels like something interpersonal is missing. I can recall a few times when people asked me if I wanted to accompany them to check that new skate park out, and when we arrived it was packed. Not just do I not know anyone around me, but it's also this weird combination of looking around so I don't run into people, and being unfamiliar with the obstacles. Then I'll usually go with the skate park flow and do basic tricks. I struggle to push myself out of my comfort zone. In 2016 and 2017, I filmed a lot of videos in one of my local skate parks. The main reason I hung out there was that I knew I'd be alone 9 out of 10 times. That skate park was the opposite of what people would call a good one, but I didn't care. It made me feel comfortable and like I belonged there. No one's around that I'd disturb and no one that bothers me. Later in 2017, the same town built another skate park. It has a type of flow that beginners can get used to, mixed with advanced obstacles like a harbor. They set this park next to the central train station. And as you can guess now, that's where it lost me. Too many people. They just walk around and watch the skating. I know it can be appealing to look at skateboarding, but I get anxious when people watch me skate. I went to this park 3 times in my life. And I did a 50-50 grind down the harbor once, which I wish someone would have recorded. The only time I can ever see myself going there again would be during the morning hours of a weekday. When it comes to street spots, it highly depends on who's skating with me. I haven't skated a street spot on my own in a while. If I find myself going out and street skating, it's usually an empty parking lot on a Sunday. I feel uncomfortable when there are people around. Skating is loud, makes people turn around and look at you. When I'm with one or two close people that I've known for a while or simply have good chemistry with, I can push myself a little bit easier. Then, my mind has an easier time dismissing the public human traffic. I have skated one contest in my entire life. It taught me something in terms of coping with and perhaps profiting from this anxiety. There was a large non-skater crowd watching, about 150 people. We had a lot of time before the contest to warm up and do stuff. I didn't skate during the warm-up since, you guessed it, I felt anxious. I had no ambition to win or rank high in this contest. I spent the time of the warm-up visualizing what I wanted to do in my run. Since doing technical stuff requires some more concentration, thought, and warm-up, I decided to do something big and make an impression. I chose to do a boneless on the second biggest obstacle of the course. Not just because it's my favorite trick, it's also one that I can do reliably on anything high. I landed my 6-foot bonus on the second try, and I think the fact that so many people were staring at me made it easier than it would have been otherwise. Bailing out of it because I was too scared of landing just wasn't an option. I had to commit right then and there. Maybe I could train myself to transform this anxious feeling into something I might benefit from. As of now, that's the only occasion that I can remember which I turned it into something positive. I'm not a city person. Whenever I'm in one, I usually feel stressed by my surroundings. It's cool to go through one and see some famous tourist spots, but the people running all over, the cars, the noise, it gets to me. My brain, my sanity. Maybe that characteristic of mine plays a role in the skateboard anxiety. I've never had a significant problem with standing in front of the class doing a presentation. However, there is more when it comes to skateboarding, which I cannot pinpoint. Whenever people turn around because of the noise or whatever, I feel like I just became a live entertainer and a subject of criticism. I'm okay with avoiding crowded parks and street spots. Writing and recording this helped me reflect on the thoughts that crossed my mind throughout the years. I never quite understood what anxiety meant in any other aspect of life, as I couldn't relate to others' experiences. However, when I first heard about skate park anxiety, and people who feel like me, I could start to label my feelings. I hope listening to this helped you reflect on yourself, or makes you more aware of what the people around you might deal with in their heads. I will try to avoid crowded parks and spots for the rest of my life. If I ever find myself in a situation where I can't, however, I'll just go big and hope that this anxious feeling helps me commit and make an impression. Thanks everyone for listening. Make sure to check out skatepunk.eu for more podcasts, interviews, interesting articles, reviews, and more. But now, go out and skate.